can do it possibly. It doesn't let you talk so much. Since we're not recording.
Thank you.
this one would be okay. So what you'll do, we won't move it now. And then the actual graduation, you'll be here in the corner when they're getting their diplomas. The corner chair walking across. So the deans of the school, the deans of the deans of the deans, the superintendent will be lined up. And so you just have to position this camera. You might need to move it right away. Position the camera so that you can capture and come in getting their diplomas and exiting this way.
So you need to make sure that they don't trip over the table.
The speakers.
We should get you your own copy of it. So, prelude is the band, so just sort of turn around to the band from this position. Then the welcome and processional. The welcome will come up here for the welcome. And then the big camera, the back camera, will get the processional as wide as possible. And we may tell you that camera can't pick it up very easily. We'll see. We'll shoot it as wide as we can, and we might pick it up and follow it. But then it goes back to the band, so you got to move it back here by just turning this around from this position. You'll just use your pen on the camera. Yeah. And then back again to the, after the band performs, you're back again to picking up the speaker. And you'll have a transition because Mr. Rosa will switch it to that camera while you make your moves. So, and then over here.
You still got, you've got significant, you can still get a
24. Can you talk about
Saeed? Yeah.
Is he
going to
do this?
I was thinking so, but I didn't know how quickly you would feel.
Yeah, I'm only
thinking.
Oh, okay.
Would you rather be back there? Okay. Josh. So what's going to happen?
Yeah, there are a couple of different camera positions. This is one camera position. We're not introducing it. You will move this to the right and stay in this position to where it's going to come
back.
And you need dolly dolly. You could follow the introductions
take this round.
And we'll be switching between two cameras. It's on Dolly.
Oh.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting your line.
I
table.
Good evening, and welcome to Finneytown High School's Class of 2022 graduation ceremony. This event is the culmination of 13 years of hard work and perseverance on the part of the students, their families, and the employees of Finneytown Local School District. Since this night is so very special, we ask all attending to refrain from any behavior that would detract from the graduates of the ceremony. Please silence, I already had to do this, all electronic devices. We greatly appreciate your consideration and efforts in making tonight a positive experience for all involved. Now please rise as you are able and direct your attention to the door as they process in.
Thank you.
Anyone who knows me knows that I love to talk, but not necessarily in a formal setting such as this. So that, coupled with the fact that I think our graduation ceremony should be about the students rather than the adults, made me make a change this year to the program. I have decided to replace the typical speech from the principal with some stories from our students. A little over a month ago, I sent out an email to our senior class, and I called on them to play a more active role in our ceremony tonight. Many gave us some incredible speeches, and tonight we will have three additional seniors speak and share their story. It'll be interspersed throughout the ceremony, so I hope you enjoy them as much as I have in reading them. For now, I will turn the mic over to our MC for the evening, Noemi.
Good evening, everyone. I know this is not the ceremony we waited 12 years for, and some of us are missing our loved ones from this milestone in our life, but we can make the best out of this moment. Thank you to every senior who gave away their ticket to Seniors in Need, and thank you to every senior and everyone supporting the senior class who was willing to lean into the discomfort for this ceremony. I stand here before you, looking back on the 4 years of the legacy we've made together. It feels like yesterday that we were walking around the high school in sixth grade for our tour of the high school. I remember the bus ride over to the high school and everyone was talking about how we don't have to walk in a line anymore and how we can use the restroom whenever we want. Once we got to seventh grade, we found out the restroom thing was kind of a scam. We were excited to find out our schedules. I remember all of us getting Snapchat and posting, who got this class, who got this class, swipe up, swipe up. My fellow seniors, students, family and friends, welcome. I am Noemi Israel, the school captain, and I am honored to stand before you this evening as your mistress of ceremony. I would like to thank the parents, guardians, families of tonight's graduates for every permission slip signed right before we got on the bus, every teacher conference you didn't want to attend, every ride to practice, help with homework, even conquering the new math problems that you guys had to look up online, anything else that happens behind the scenes. The support you have shown has not been forgotten. Thank you again. Know that your role has played a big part in these kids' lives. To the doubters, haters, skeptics towards 2022, we made it. Some of us were told we would not make it today, but look at us now. To my class of 2022, we did it. Now we will go on to join the workforce, becoming educators, forex traders, real estate agents, getting a higher education, and so much more. Regardless if you have been in Finneytown since kindergarten, or you have been adopted to the Wildcat family in these past few years, we did it together, remember that. Take this moment to manifest your future. I will leave you with this. Do all you can today, because tomorrow is not promised. Thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce my fellow classmate, Jack Isridding, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for the playing of our national anthem. may be seated. Finneytown High School also has a number of graduates who have committed to enlisting in America's Armed Forces. Would these graduates please stand and be recognized? Anyone? There we go, there's Seth. Graduates, please remain standing. Thank you. As a sign of encouragement and recognition for next Monday being Memorial Day, we would like all in the audience who have served our country in a branch of the military to stand and be honored with our students. Of gratitude to all of you. Thank you for your service. You may now be seated.
Sorry. Now my classmate Sophie Palmer will share some words with you. Please give her a round of applause. Sophie Palmer!
That we set for ourselves, but the core truths and values that have led us all to this point. Personally, I think my eighth grade self would be proud of who I am, but simultaneously irritated that I rejected her advice. In fact, I'm sure I'll feel the exact same way when I look back at this in another 4 years, and that's okay. This is the time in our lives where we can develop our opinions, take more risks, ask questions, and arguably the most important, go to the restroom without having to raise our hands first. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to introduce our platform guests. Please stand as I read your name. Ms. Lindsay Lee, Vice President of Board of Education, Ms. Jaleesa McMillan, Mr. James Reeve, Board of Education members, Dr. Lori Banks, Superintendent, Dr. Jen Dinan, Assistant Superintendent, Ms. Carol Miller, Principal, Ms. Lisa Samuel, Assistant Principal, Mr. Anton Walker, Assistant Principal, Ms. Tammy Neese, Practices Facilitator, Rachel Thompson, Alumni Guest Speaker, Career Specialist at Diamond Oaks Technology and Career Development Center, Ms. Laura Dahmen. It is an honor to introduce our Superintendent, Dr. Lori Banks.
All right, Finneytown seniors, you've made it. You have arrived at the end of one chapter in your life and will soon begin living your next. This chapter in your story includes appearances and supporting roles by family, friends, teachers, administrators, coaches, counselors, and so many more. Each person is a connection, evidence of you being seen, of you being valued, and that you matter. Each connection is evidence of your impact on others. The impact of connection can never be fully realized in the moment, but it will be realized. Your chapter is filled with moments, brief periods of time, maybe a moment where a teacher told you they saw you as a marine biologist, a moment where a coach said, keep showing up, keep working hard. You've got this, I believe in you. A moment when someone special shared space with you during a really hard time and said, you are not alone. A moment when a friend made you laugh so hard you almost cried. These are moments of joy, awe, wonder, curiosity, frustration, anger, sadness, and many more. It is these collection of moments that will guide you into the next chapter of your story. As you prepare for the next chapter, I would like to share with you some words that have influenced me during times of challenge and change, which you're about to embark on. The quotes I will share with you are from Eleanor Roosevelt. In her early life, Eleanor suffered from a lack of confidence. She was shy and preferred to always be in the background. She would grow into a young woman driven by a purpose and exuding confidence and became a fierce servant leader. She identified a purpose that called her to do things that challenged her because that purpose mattered. So class of 2022, here are four quotes from one of the most influential women in our country's history that I hope inspire you as they have me on my journey. First, in the one quote I use most often, you must do the thing you think you cannot do, because you can do it. Only you can define what you can accomplish. Being uncomfortable and stretched means you are living and learning. Second, do what you feel in your heart to be right, for you will be criticized anyway. There will always be somebody ready to judge and criticize you. If you always do the right thing in your heart, that criticism and judgment become less important. Third, You have to accept whatever comes. And the only important thing is that you meet it with the best you have to give. Do your best. And your best will ebb and flow based on life circumstances. But always do your best. And finally, life was meant to be lived. And curiosity must be kept alive. One must never, for whatever reason, turn his back on life. Living is staying curious, learning, being vulnerable, and showing up. Finneytown Class of 2022, before you start your next chapter, take time to remember and reflect. As you begin the next chapter, be confident, curious, vulnerable, and do the things you think you cannot do, because all of us believe you can. We are Finneytown. Congratulations, Class of 2022.
At this time, I am honored to introduce our guest speaker. Please welcome our guest speaker of this evening, Rachel Thompson.
I'm a tall human. Can I just take it? Okay. Sorry, y'all. I'm a tall person, so I have to redirect. Hi, everybody. Good evening. My name is Rachel Thompson. Can I just take this off? Yeah, I'll just do this. There we go. Hi, everybody. My name is Rachel Thompson, and it's an absolute honor and a privilege to be the alumni commencement speaker for the graduating class of 2022. Congratulations to you all. I'm a very proud alumni from the class of 2011 and your friendly neighborhood real estate agent that can help you buy, sell, or invest in properties. I'll be stage left with business cards after this. It's an immense privilege to be here today, and I'm so excited for all of you to go and conquer the world. So my Finneytown story begins as I transferred here in the middle of middle school, seventh grade. I was raised a military brat, so Finneytown was the seventh school that I had attended in my very short lifetime. And although being the new kid was fun, exciting, and sometimes traumatic, it made me into the professional extrovert that I am today. And as any 13-year-old teenager would be, I was initially really devastated that my mom pulled me from my school and my friends that I really loved, especially when she told me we were going to Finneytown, because what is a Finneytown? Like, are we Finneys? I don't really know. So from day one, I was really supported by my teachers, my fellow students, and even some of my best friends are still some of my fellow Finneytown classmates. And so existing in a really small, tight-knit school gave me really a lot of comfort. I could see the same faces every day and, you know, always got to talk to everybody when we were walking through the halls. And even talking to friends that went to bigger schools, it's crazy to think that, you know, they would walk through the halls and see strangers. Like, that's such a weird concept to me. So the Finneytown community is extremely unique, and it's truly a village where parents, educators, coaches, administrators are all collectively involved in the building of students. As an adult, I look back and I was so incredibly grateful to all of my teachers at this school, and their passion, dedication will always stay with me. I vividly remember cramming for Brinus's tree test, and the fear of losing my B bills at night kept me up at night. I remember the trial and error of the 50% rule when I was in school. Where if you didn't fill out the assignment, you just got an automatic 50%. So that kind of took over, and, you know, we would just take our 50 instead of doing it. I remember Mrs. Deed's annual story time of Molly Lou Lemon and how it always brought tears to her no matter how many times she read it. I remember seeing Miss Counts every morning as my high school guidance counselor, and she had such an impact on my time at Finneytown. And I remember Mr. Munchmore's multicultural literature class, and he always allowed us about 10 minutes in the beginning of class to read, just dissect, and review the Jersey Shore episode that came the night before. Because Jim, Tan, and Laundry was definitely an era back then when I was in school. So being in a small school gave us the versatility as students to try anything without the stereotypical pressures of, you know, staying one-dimensional. When I went to Finneytown, the cheerleader was also in the marching band, and the soccer player also was in play, and he did musicals. I myself was a dedicated bench warmer for the girls' basketball team. I have a little PTSD seeing these lines and remember running suicides in this gym. And so I was involved in a lot of different things, and Finneytown gave me the ability to explore and experiment, which is very rare in a lot of schools. I remember I played tennis for a semester, partially to think I was Serena Williams, but the other half was that I just didn't want to be in class, and the matches would take me out of class. Finneytown created a safe space around us and enabled me with the confidence to be unafraid to try new things, which is a guiding principle throughout my life. After graduation, I was set on attending Ohio University to become a high school guidance counselor. And 3 months later, I was brought back home because, newsflash, college is very expensive. My brief yet lively time at OU was full of new experiences, their infamous Halloween weekend, and many failed algebra exams that brought tears to my eyes. Having to start again, I transferred to the University of Cincinnati and changed my major another 2 times after that. So you may call it being indecisive. I call it being an Aquarius, so, you know, I just roll with it. So I finally settled on a degree in communication, which is the best degree to have when you're tired of being in school and you want all your credits to transfer over. My communication degree gave me permission to intellectually roam and feed my curiosity in endless ways. I dabbled in classes like Arabic culture studies, Latin American history, interpersonal communication, rhetorical theory, classes that really changed my mindset, and being able to understand human psychology, cultures, and the deep interconnectedness that we all share as human beings. With my newfound liberal arts freedom, I was able to participate in a month-long study abroad program in Antigua, Guatemala, and that was an experience that really changed the trajectory of my life. Guatemala really gifted me with my experiences to change my worldview, my fluency in Spanish, también yo hablo español, slight flex, and the humility of knowing how small that we all are in this big world. My insatiable desire to continue to explore the world made traveling an instant passion for me, and I knew that I always needed more. Traveling has a way of gifting you with divine interactions from complete strangers that can change everything for you. When I was visiting Barcelona in 2016, I encountered a woman from Indiana, and she told me she taught English in Spain. And I was completely mind blown. And I knew immediately that I had to do the same, because if somebody from Indiana can do it, I can definitely do it. So 2 years after that experience, I worked in a job full-time after college. I got fired from this said job, but it was the best thing that ever happened to me. And about 6 months after that, I decided to move to Madrid, Spain to teach English. So upon my arrival, I had a one-way ticket, about $3,000, no job, no friends. I had an Airbnb for 2 weeks and an unlimited supply of things. And I just remember every morning when I would leave my Airbnb, it was right in front of the Royal Palace of Madrid, and that gave me all the charge I needed to continue. That faith was very powerful, and I knew that I could do anything that I put my mind to. And I trusted in myself and a mantra from The Alchemist, which I highly encourage all of you all to read. And the quote says, "When you want something, all of the universe conspires in helping you achieve it. And the universe always makes a way when you are aligned to your highest purpose." Coupled with my faith in myself, I had a special type of fearlessness that I protected with every fiber of my being. People would always ask me, "Aren't you afraid? Aren't you scared? Aren't you nervous?" And in life, people will try to speak fear into your uniquely designed plan. And you cannot let their fear derail you from your mission. Fear and doubt is the graveyard of dreams. Protect your dreams with all of your might. And another quote that I just love is from The Four Agreements. The author, Don Miguel Ruiz, says, "To be alive is the biggest fear that humans have. Death is not the biggest fear that we have. Our biggest fear is taking the risk to be alive and express what we really are." On the other side of fear is life. In my life, I've rode a camel in the Sahara Desert on New Year's Eve. I've seen Beyonce and Jay-Z in concert in London, which was amazing. I've watched nightfall over the twinkling lights of the Eiffel Tower. I've lived on an Italian farm surrounded by rolling hills and sunflowers. I've wandered through Mexico alone and watched a full moon rise over the city. I've learned to salsa dance in Havana, Cuba, and countless other stories that are not appropriate for this graduation ceremony. I can't, off the record. But imagine if I had listened to fear. This full yet unorthodox life of mine has taught me many things. In my 29 years of living, I've lived abroad for 2 years. I've traveled to 13 countries. I've attended 3 different schools and changed my major another 3 times. And I've had 26 jobs, 2 of which I got fired from. The myth of adulting tells us that we should have a dream life and a career that we put all of our energy towards accomplishing it. And life is not as picture perfect as it seems. There's gonna be a lot of unexpected changes, a lot of pitfalls, a lot of failures, and a lot of hard decisions that require you to dig deep and really, truly remember who you are. Failure is never failure when you learn from the experience. Period. Oh, thank you, guys. I encourage you all as graduates to strive to have a grateful heart for all the experiences you have, because everything is always working towards your highest good, even when it doesn't feel like it. And one day, everything is going to make sense. I promise you that. Graduates, the path that lies ahead for each of you is unknown, but each path is uniquely yours. We are each gifted with an individual mission in this life, and comparing your path to anyone else's is the form of betrayal to yourself and your gifts. In the world of social media and imposter syndrome, stand tall in the truth that what is for you will never miss you. Each of you hold an immense power within that can conquer anything that you put your mind to. The human mind is the most powerful thing on this earth. The young, daring minds of the world have put men on the moon with hand-drawn calculations. They've cured diseases and given instant access to a world of information right in our palms. All things in this world begin as a thought. And each of you hold the infinite ability to be a creator. Anything is possible in this life, and I mean anything. And although our minds are powerful, they are highly impressionable, and our thoughts create our reality and our truth. When I believed that I could move to Spain with every ounce of my heart, it was my truth and my guiding light, and I didn't let anyone talk me out of it. I conquered it, and now it's a part of my story. It's imperative to speak life into yourself and not allow the fear of others to stray you from your unique path. What you believe is what you receive. If you lead with positivity and light, you will find it. If you lead with self-doubt and fear, it will find you. Choose your truth and be open to what the world brings you. Anything in this world is possible, and you all are more than capable to achieve what you desire. So with that, I have a little assignment for our graduates. I would be honored to close with some affirmations to send you on your journey. So please repeat after me, loud and proud. Graduates, please repeat after me. I'm sorry, I hyped you up. Okay, now we're ready, you ready? I am powerful beyond measure. I am beautifully and uniquely me. You guys can do it louder, It's your graduation, you gotta do it louder. I bring value to the world just by being me.
I bring value to the world just by being me.
I am worthy of all that I desire.
I am worthy of all that I desire.
Fear does not serve me or my dreams. Everything is working towards my highest good. Louder. Yeah, someone said louder. Louder. All the tools for my success are at my fingertips. I have infinite wisdom, and all the answers exist within me. That one was kind of long. I'm sorry, y'all. I trust in myself and my path. I am proud of myself for making it to this moment. I am brave and I am a conqueror. Beautiful. Thank you all so much. Many congratulations to you all. Go and conquer the world. Thank you.
Thank you.
strange question, but do you all like raspberries? Just raise your hand if you do. Okay, wow, we got a good amount of raspberry fans out there. The reason I asked this is I like raspberries so much that I wrote part of my college application essay about them. So your definition of like probably varies from my definition just a little bit. No, but the reason I ask and I mention this is I draw comparisons with my experience at Finneytown to the growth of a raspberry bush. This right here are raspberry seeds. This is where the class of 2022 and I started from. Metaphorically, of course. I immigrated to America from the Philippines at a young age. I attended three different schools leading up to my enrollment in Finneytown in the second grade. So it was pretty chaotic. Yet I grew into, let me get it out here, a small sapling right here. See, that's me. With the help of this class, and despite being so seemingly insignificant, this sapling laid out a strong blueprint for later success. Many of my teachers were a source of support for me from my elementary through high school years. I know they were a source of support for my peers as well. They held me accountable and high to my potentials. My teachers were my support. Since I'm a visual learner, I'm gonna kind of demonstrate what that looks like to you. So here's what it is. Let me get this out right here. So right here, there's a nice little tripod, as you can see, right here. Let me set it up. It's kind of stuck. I put it right here. This right here, these are my teachers. Tripods support a lot of things, but in this case, it's going to be us, the sapling. My class, this class, I describe them as water to my roots, and I the water to theirs. Humid Brent and Whitaker view days, Miss Furlong's ghostly Halloween kick the code day, and Miss Hubby's Cupid Shuffle cleanup song played in tandem to our youthful, paint-smeared smiles. Whether we do it or not, we learn from each other through these experiences, and it made us understand what power we hold when we have each other. And then came middle school. I don't know about you, but middle school, it was something. Like, middle school is this weird span where you feel like you're at the top because you're an eighth grader, but at the same time, you're an eighth grader. So, I guess what I mean by this is that this was a big time for growth, trying new things and trends. Some trends we'd rather do without, yet we grew. Maybe a bit awkwardly, but growth is growth. We began to take a bigger form. Not right there. Thank you. We started realizing our potential, and we started to realize what transformation would be coming next, high school. Personally, I did a lot during my high school years, but like many of you, I was figuring out my interests in combination with growing intellectually. It felt like golden rays of sunshine glowed so bright on us that nothing could stop us. Well, that aged poorly. Second semester, sophomore year, COVID arrived. 2 weeks turned into a month, and a month into a year. It was a long night under squid ink skies. It took some time, but eventually, bird calls nibbled us awake, and with sagging smiles, we remained evergreen. We came back, junior year, and now senior year. We grew and accomplished in so many different ways. Fortified from what was lost, emerged new ventures from our absent high school years. Let me get a bigger bush out for you to show. Yeah, right here. Get that right there. I saw some of you make it to state for your sports, or get
I would like to take this opportunity to honor our highest ranked vocational student. Please welcome Karina McGar.
Thank you, Ms. Simmel, and our final reflection will be given by Jamie Young Coates. Please give it to kids. I'm so honored and proud to stand here today amongst the people that became world classmates and faculty. You y'all become our family. The world we are living in right now seems to be in complete chaos. We've been through a major pandemic, global warming, and a world divided by justice and war. But through it all, the class of 2022 pushed, and now we are here ready to leave all behind what we've known to become a movement in a world full of the unknown. Now, I don't know about y'all, but when I started this journey, I felt invincible. I felt I had everything planned out from the first day of school, fifth from freshman year, to how I was going to be a star athlete, achieving nothing but greatness out of the field. My teachers will love me, my friends will always have my back, and my student involvement will shape my classmates into the best version of themselves they can be. I was going to be the man. But looking back on those years, I think about the saying I heard. If you want to make God laugh, tell him about your plans. I love God with all my heart, just like I know that. You see, life isn't a plan, life isn't a chart you map out on a board that you make from cuts out of a magazine. It is completely known that you just don't know. That no matter what you do, how you plan, we have no idea where this life will take us. But one thing you can count on for sure is that for certain, in fact, that we build up the ball, or we build this up, or we build this tomorrow. And then we have to realize that messing up or changing course is not a bad thing. It doesn't mean that your journey stops here or that you completely lost sight of your dreams. It means that we have an even better shot at greatness because we only have the best around you. Failure isn't the opposite of success, it's a part of it. Let me write that back to y'all. Failure isn't the opposite of success, it's a part of it. It's the foundation of living and learning. Most great people have the greatest achievement just one step behind the greatest failures. We have so many people telling us, do this, go here, apply to this college, take these courses, and why do they do it? Because somehow they want to help us prevent our mistakes. Mistakes in a way that we need. But at the end of the day, it's you living this life, a life too short to live for anybody else. My friend, life was cut way too short. Most things don't go as planned because we can't account for everything. Alex Harris had it planned out. His amazing talents and cool personality was going to take him afar and look out that he was behind. He was even in my plans to make sure we all good and we all get to the top together. And that through all our successes, we will never forget our bond and where we came from. So I want to try to get around with the thoughts of my boy, Alex, for long as I
Next, we'll start with Mr. Crowley. He's going to come up for roll call of the graduates.
Thank you. Michael Borders. Elizabeth Kane. like to introduce the Dean of Cupkey House, Ms. Heather Howard.
Dean of the House of Pym, Matt Brightness.
Charles Allen. Wesley Bruder. Right.
Marquez Walker.
Danielle Bird. Thomas Michael Leeson.
Thank you.
Everyone, please remain seated while the graduates leave the stadium. Well done, the gym.
We're sick, that's good.
Graduates, please proceed to the FD to pick up your polo.
Oh, yeah.